Hello and welcome back. I have just cleaned the screen on my camcorder. So it's 1 p.m. It's 1 p.m. Friday. And I just hit record 3 hours and then it's about this old Intel processor CPUs. I've been watching off the Wikipedia. Wikipedia, that's a perfect place. The Wikipedia in English. They have some long articles. They got some long text about all kind of stuff. So I just look at that 3 hours in Danish and record a lot of videos. And I did that tonight too, to like 3 a.m. and I to 4 a.m. So I did sleep like 4 a.m. tonight and got up like a little bit more after 9 a.m. Then I did start to record this in Danish. But I like to record a bit in English. But my English is not as good as my Danish. Because I'm not English, I'm an old Danish YouTuber and computer gamer. But I did buy this old Intel. This Intel 186. I did buy that last night, so of course I would like to learn more about it. And learn more about the old Intel processors. To the PC, that's to the PC, the personal computers. So I have to read more about that, so I understand what it is and the history and how these CPUs are working. But that's very complicated. That's very complicated how the CPU is working with the codes and all kind of stuff. So I've been looking at that the last 3 hours. I have an old high school degree and I have started to librarian like more than 20 years ago, 25 years ago. In the 1990s I did study to librarian like 3 years, but I never finished the education and I did not like the education. So I did never finish my education, but when I was on this librarian school, I did in the 90s, like 1996, I did use the computers and the internet connection on the school. They had some old Intel 386 in the library, and then in the computer rooms they have some Intel 486, I think. The 486 DX something, maybe DX 4 or SX, I'm not sure. But then they did later, after many years, they got some Pentium. I not remember if they had, maybe they had some Pentium to the students. It's the first version of the Pentium computers. So I got my first PC. I got like year 2010. That was a kind of Dell office computer. Did buy online with a GeForce graphic card, but that was not really a gamer computer. That was not made like a gamer computer. That was an office computer with a GeForce graphic card, so I could play like Microsoft Flight Simulator 2000. I spent many thousand hours to sit through that, the Microsoft Flight Simulator 2000 and Microsoft Flight Simulator 2002 and 2004. I did spend many thousands of hours. Actually, I have the old Microsoft Flight Simulator 2004. I did find it down here. I have it like here. That's old Microsoft, that's close 10 years ago. Yes, I have to open because this CD is getting out. So let's fix that, put it back. No, that's the old Microsoft Flight Simulator. That's something, if you have some old computers, you can install. But I don't remember how to do that and the codes. I think you have to activate the codes. Says keep disk 4 in the CD driving. So that's why we have the CD there. That's, you have to install it. 1, 2. We are missing the CD number 3. Yes, 1, 2. No, that's the CD number 3. We are missing seat. No, here we have it. There. 1, 2, 3, and 4. But I think you need to activate. You need to activate this game with a code or something. I'm not sure. You cannot just install it. I think. Maybe you have the code. No, you have some information there. No, that's information how to install it in. In Swedish and Danish. Yes, this is the instruction. That's some old program. Some are playing this game just for fun on the YouTube. They're making video about not just like this one, but old game from the before year 2000. Old PC games. And I think they're using real old computers. They are using this old Intel 486 computers with old graphic card. They are playing the old PC games, and they make a video about that for YouTube. They do that. Many do that. Not many, but some do that. Of course, many of you can have many good computer games like 20 years ago, more than 20 years ago. Yes, year 2000, that's 22 years ago. Now here 2022 now. And soon 2023. So you could have good computer games like year 1998 or 99, something like that. Let's put it back. Now put a rubber band. Let's put it back. Yes, but this video, this video recording, I call looking at PC gamer hardware. That was my plan, to record a lot of a video up in English about PC gamer computers. But you can have a PC gamer computer from like year 1995 or 6, something like that. Like the Intel 486. So I would like to get the old old gamer computer. Just for fun, but I really need a fast computer. I need a real gamer computer for myself. I can play the modern games because this Intel Core i5, the 8th generation, is old. I cannot play much games on my Steam. I have a GeForce GTX 1050 with 4 GB memory. Yes, that's a list of Intel processors, but I have a lot of game on my Steam account. Yes, I got buy a lot of games. That's my Steam account. I have a long list of games there. That's the 3D Mark program. I was playing American Truck Simulator, but I cannot run it anymore. I have like 1,000 videos about American Truck Simulator. We have they're doing some rework of the old California map. They're doing some rework of the old, that's the oldest part of the American Truck Simulator. Yes, I'll use this, that's for a drone. I was flying FPV drone a little bit. I did like to start that, but then I got into all the steps. I have it here. That's the propeller for the drone, this one. They are still working. And I've been flying a little bit in my living room. I need to do that just to practice. I have it. That's the charger we have here. Here we have the batteries. We got the batteries from the drone. It's right there. Just need to find the transmitter. The transmitter is out here. But this is why I use this one. Of course, I was working. I have some oil, but I'm not really clean up. Got more oil propellers there. Of course, I did buy. I have it up here. A lot of propellers up there for the drone. So I have not given up my drone flying. And that's, this drone can record videos. You can use for YouTube. No, I think I have the transmitter is out here. That's some for the drones. No, that's a screen. That's a FPV screen for drone. And now I put it. Oh, yes, that's a screen. You can send the video from the drone, then you can look the camera. But that's just very dusty. I don't know why it should be inside. That should be inside this box. No, I did buy like $150, but that's a few years ago. But this is a FPV screen. I have it down there, and then I think the transmitter is something down here, somewhere here. But we are not looking at that, so this is why I use this. But I'm early retired, I'm age 56 soon. And I became YouTuber like 8 years ago in summer 2014. And I don't have family, I don't have kids or family. So most of my time I'm spending alone in my apartments. So I need to have this computer I can play, because I'm living my life alone in my apartment. So I need to be able to play computer games. Of course, that you have so many long weeks, you have some long days and weeks just sitting alone in apartments. And this is why I was able to record that many videos. I soon have more than 23,000 videos on my YouTube channel MongoTV. I have that because I'm just sitting in my apartment day and night, and I have my computer open, so I just record some videos like now. I have my camcorders there. I just record, then I go and upload. Then I did that every day, like soon 8 years. And game videos, then I did record video from outside, then it got to like 23,000 videos. So this is why this video have a weird number, like MongoTV 8,000 something, 8,800 part 3. That's because I have 23,000 videos. I cannot just have a video with just a name. Because I'm saving a copy. This video I will save a copy on my hard drives, and later my plan is to buy some big hard drives. I have many, many thousands of gigabytes of video, but later I will buy some big external hard drives, like 16 gigabytes, something big. now we have the five terabytes. I could not find this, so I have to buy 2 terabytes. But at least I should get. But I use maybe sometime I use 2,000 gigabytes every month. So that's close to every month, every second month I have to spend $100 to buy. This is why I have to buy the 4 terabytes or 5, because that's cheaper. And actually I have only 800 gigabytes left, so actually I already have to buy next month. I have to spend money to buy some more storage. But later I will buy some really big storage, like 16,000 gigabytes, 60 terabytes. But I don't have money for that, and then I cannot just have 23,000 folders with no names on folders, no names, then it would be a total mess. This is why I have numbers. I have numbers of my videos. But they are updating the California road network. That's old state that it start with California, Nevada, and Arizona. I think that's old part of the American Truck Simulator. So they are doing some rework. I think you can click the photos now. But I cannot really drive anymore because it's lagging really bad. I can barely drive, yes, but you know, I can start the game, but I cannot drive. Then I was I'm playing this city skyline, this city building, but the game sound is not working there. So, and it's not running very good. It's running bad. Then I have an echo game. I was playing this more than 1,000 hours. Got 1,900 hours, 2,000 hours. We have an update. We can take the updates. They have a big release a few days, the 28 April, version 9.5. So that's a game I like to play again. And of course I cannot do that with a 20 years old, 25 years old PC. But this is not why I like to have this old gamer PCs from like the 90s. That's just for fun. Of course I can use it on my YouTube channel. I can record in English, because all these gamer computers, that's the same the whole world. We only have this Intel company. And we have this gamer brands like Asus and IBM, all these big brands in the gaming. That's the same global all over the world. So many hundreds of millions of people have been using this gamer PC, gamer computers. Now we have the 9.5, but I've not been able like 2 years to play the game. So I like to go back. I had my own server. I had an old Echo server, so I had like 1,000. On my YouTube channel we have 1,000 hours of game video from this. Yes, now the game is updating. I was playing Dungeons. I think I did never play the Dungeons number 3. That was actually kind of fun game. I don't remember, but I think I did play the Dungeons number 2. Yes, play like 35 hours. That was kind of a fun game. So I never played Dungeons number 3. I should try to do that. That's an old game, Skyrim, but I got stuck there. I only play like 2 hours, 160 minutes. And I was playing EVE Online. I have 200 hours EVE Online. I still have my old accounts. GTA, I have 1,000 1100 hours on my GTA. We have another update there, but I